In this video, I'm going to show three examples of ways you can replace the if or ifs function with the switch function. In this worksheet, I have a table where the first three columns are name, job title, and salary. What we want to do is calculate the total compensation for each name when factoring the bonus in, which you can find in the percentage for in the yellow table. In column D, I calculated the total compensation using nested if functions. And in column E, I want to do the same thing, but use the switch function instead. Now, in case you don't know, the switch function is a logical function that compares an expression to the value we give it. And if the comparison is true, then we want to have it output something. So if we go back to the if function here, the expression in this case would be the job title before the logical operator here, and the value would be the partner, which is after the logical operator here. So in cell E2, I'm going to type out equals to switch and do tab. And we have the first argument as the expression, which is the cell we're referencing. So in this case, it's going to be cell B2 or the job title, comma, the values. What value do we want to compare the expression to, which will be partner in this case. And we want to make sure that we have no typos for this either, comma. The result will be the calculation itself for finding the total bonus. And we can do salary times open parentheses 1.25, and in this case I'm just adding the value 1 to the percentage and multiplying it by the salary to find the total compensation, and then do close parentheses and then do comma, and we want to repeat the same process as before except for the expression. In this case, we want to represent another value for the expression, which is off console, and to calculate the total compensation for that, we just do the same thing, salary times, but instead of 1.25, we do 1.2 instead, since the bonus for that is 20%, and then do comma, and the next level we want to look at is the associate, so we're going to type out, in quotes, associate, and then do comma, and then just do salary times 1.15, and we have the last level, which is paralegal, so I can just type out paralegal, in quotes, do comma, and then the calculation will be salary times 1.1, and then close this out, then press enter, and we get back the total compensation for each level here. Now, if there was a job title that didn't exist, or you made a typo somewhere in a job title, then you can go back to the switch function, and you can enter a default value as the last argument. So this default value would represent the else in the if functions, and if there are no other values that are equal to true, then it would default to this value instead. So we're just going to say default value is 0 and press enter. Let's say that we call this as ASSOC, and if I press enter, we get back 0 instead. And the if function evaluated this as false as well, since this job title doesn't exist in our conditions. Let's compare the two formulas together. We can see that the switch function looks much cleaner than the nested if functions. There are a lot less parentheses used with the switch function compared to the nested if functions. And if you made a typo somewhere in your formula, then it could be easy to identify and fix. Now, what's funny is that since we're given a table with the job title and the associated bonus percentages, we could have also solved this using the XLOOKUP or the VLOOKUP function. In cell F2, I'm going to show how you can do this with XLOOKUP. I'm going to type out equals to XLOOKUP, and the lookup value will be the job title here, comma. The lookup array will be the values in column G, excluding the header, comma. And the return array will be calculation, which in this case will be the salary, then do times, open parentheses, 1 plus the values in column H, excluding the header, and then close this out, and if no value is found, then return 0 instead, and close this out, and press enter, and we get the exact same values in columns D and E. If we didn't have the bonus percentage table, then we could either make one ourselves to use the XLOOKUP function, or we can go back to the alternative method with the switch function, or even the nested if functions if you wanted to. In the second example worksheet, I'm going to show how the ifs function with an S compares to the switch function. Columns A and B of this table focuses on the student's name and score, and we want to translate each student's score into a letter grade based on the given conditions. In column C, I did this with the ifs function, which you can see in the formula bar, and when compared to the nested if function in the first example worksheet, it looks much cleaner. For this situation, you're going to come across with one of the limitations of the switch function, which is that it can only compare exact matches against the value and the expression. So you can't really use logical operators like the greater than or less than signs. There is a workaround to this limitation where you can set the expression to true and then do logical comparisons similar to the ifs function. In cell D2, I'm going to type out equal to switch and then set the expression to true, comma, the value 1 will be the score is greater than or equal to 90. And if that's true, then we want to return the letter A, comma, the value 2 will be the score once again, but this time greater than or equal to 80, then return B. If the score is greater than or equal to 70, we want to return C. And if the score is greater than or equal to 60, then we want to return D. And finally, if it's like any value below 60, or the default value will be F in this case. And close this out and press enter. And we get back all the letter grades in this column, same as what you would see in column C. Now, for this type of situation, it might just be better to use the ifs function instead, as that's better at handling logical operators using the greater than or less than sign. For the final example, I have this worksheet where one table shows the job title you would see in the legal service industry, and another table that has one column for keyword and category. Our main goal is to see if a keyword exists in the job title column, and if it does, then return the appropriate category. If a keyword does not exist, then we want to return support staff by default. And column B shows you can do this with the combination of the ifs, isNumber, and search functions. We will be doing something similar in column C by using the switch, isNumber, and search functions as well. In cell C2, I'm going to type out equals to switch, and for our expression, we're going to have the boolean value of true, comma. Now in this part, we're going to be using the isNumber and the search function. So I'm going to type out isNumber, and then do search. And we have the description returns the number of characters at which a specific character or text string is first found, reading from left to right and not case sensitive. So basically what the search function does is that it's going to try to find a specific text within a text you reference, and it's going to return the position number for that text. So if I label the find text as partner in this case, since we want to search up the first keyword as partner, comma, within text will be the job title here. And for the starting num, that's an optional argument that we can just leave blank. So this function will return a number if the keyword exists. And if it does return a number, the isNumber function is going to return true. Otherwise, it's going to return false. And if the values return true, that means it's going to be matched up to this expression here. And it would output the category, which in this case will be leadership. And you want to close this isNumber function out as well. So there's no like open parentheses. And now I'm going to do comma for the next keyboard, which in this case will be associate. So I'm going to do isNumber of search and do quotes associate quote. And for the text will be job title here. And just close this out and close this out. And what we want to return as a result will be legal team. And then comma. And finally, we have the last keyboard here from the list, which is paralegal. So what I'm just going to do to make things easier is that I'm going to copy and paste this formula here. Do Control C and just paste it here. And I'm just going to change this to a paralegal. So if paralegal appears in a text, then we want to return the value of paralegal team. And then comma. And if the keyword doesn't exist in the job title, then we want to return a default value of support staff. And then close this out and press enter. And we get back all the categories this time based on the keyword here. So you can see that senior partner and managing partner both have partner in it. So we would get back leadership. Paralegal assistant and nursing paralegal both have the word paralegal in it. So we would get back paralegal team. Same thing for junior associate here. We get legal team. And for the support staff, since none of the keywords exist, we would get back the support staff value instead. That's pretty much it on how you can use the switch function instead of the if or ifs function for certain scenarios. Personally, while the switch function looks cleaner, I would still go with using the ifs function instead, since the syntax is much easier to understand. In the end, it'll come down to your own preference. If you found this video to be helpful, then you should also check out another video I uploaded before, where I talk about these 4x lookup tricks that you probably never heard of or used before. As always, please like and comment down below what else you'd want to see, and if you haven't already, subscribe. Until then, I'll see you guys next time.